Hi guys and welcome to another vlog. Today I'm standing in front of you with this is the Hyundai Santro. Straight away we can talk about the exterior design. Up front you get this beautiful light. This is halogen light and just below you get fog light, black insert and the grill looks massive. Two-in hook is placed here. It's a chrome treatment. Yeah, it goes all the way on and this is the hook placement and also the grill is absolutely massive. Yeah. The grill is absolutely massive and just below the bumper you get a clamp. It will just hit the speed breaker and moving on to the front, you get this massive typical Hyundai logo and it get this dual wipers versus a nozzle. Yeah, it get dual nozzles also, small nozzles on both sides and the windscreen is absolutely big enough, massive enough you can say. While moving on to the side profile, it get this small tire, no alloy wheels and the tire size is happens to be Versa tire size. Yeah, the tire size is written over here, 165, 70 or 14 is the tire size, but Versa alloy wheel Hyundai. The top spec model doesn't get alloy wheel, that model only get what wheel cap, that's also coarse cutting and here no chrome treatment, that's also obviously coarse cutting. But here on the side view mirror you get turn indicator, but the side view mirror cannot be fold electrically for the top spec model also. And this is absolutely cheap indeed. This thing, we need the door handle that opens like this. This is absolutely cheap. This is obviously reminds you about the Hyundai Ion. And this is the side profile. The car is not as big as we expected, but the wheel cap, design of the wheel cap is obviously a nice. And on the rear you get drum brake, on the front you get disc brake and no black colored beading. And this car also doesn't get a shark fin antenna, but that is not expected in this price point. Ordinary antenna and it get this beautiful spoiler. And while coming to the rear, the tail light is nice and to avoid the visual bulk, there is a black treatment you can see. That's for avoiding the visual bulk and no reverse parking sensor and no reverse parking camera either. And this is typical Hyundai logo. Santro written over there, sports written over there and tail light is also nice. And this is the control to open the fuel cap and there is no electromagnetic boot, so I want to open the boot like this. There's two way to open the boot, pull the lever from there and also use the key. And there is no parcel tray, obviously you can see that there is no parcel tray. And you know what, it gets spare wheel, but there is so many stuffs loaded here, because of that I can't take the spare wheel and key. And let me move on to the rear door. Rear door opens large and wide and door pockets that are large enough, you can keep 1 liter bottle. So I kept 1 liter bottle. Yeah, actually I kept 1 liter bottle. And while closing the door, I do realize that there is no air refill inside the cabin. Handle placement along with no hook placement. Handle placement along with no hook placement. And no scoop door seat bags, but you get obviously a maxine holders. And here door handle and dual tone colors on the door pads, silver treatment, typical Hyundai silver treatment on the. And also there is no adjustable seat belt height, that is not exceptional for the rear seat, but that's exceptional for the front seat. And the height will be sometimes more complicated with this car because the seat headrest height cannot be adjusted. And also it gets rear rest even, that's nice touch. Meanwhile, front seat also doesn't get adjustable headrest. That is not a nice touch or impressive touch. We are not adequate with that feature. That's also a coarse cutting. And also it get this massive speaker. That's a nice touch. And obviously rare as events, it will obviously gives you good amount of air conditioning. And here you get handle placement along with no hook placement. Handle placement along with no hook placement. No light placement in the sender, and this is for brake light, and this is the light for the sender. That is only applicable for the front seat. That will not give you good amount of bright light in rear passenger seat, and the legroom is decent, headroom is also decent, but the headroom is not good as such because there is no adjustable headrest and my head is almost touching here. Let me move on to the front seat. There is so many cost cutting is happens in this car, but in from Hyundai we expected more things, and here it doesn't get what passive entry, remote keyless entry, but passive entry is not expected where from this price point. We get keyhole to open and close the car, but it gets remote control also to open and close. Now the car is open, door opens large and wide. Yeah, you can see door opens large and wide. And where's the power window control? Power window control is in the center, and also you can lock the power window control. And to fold the side view mirror, there is no switch, but I think you can add aftermarket switch for folding the side view mirror. Here there's a dummy switch here, because of that I tell you that. And here this is for adjusting the outside side view mirror. There is no ORVM in this outside side view mirror and rear view mirror. And here seat cannot be adjusted, there is no dead pedal, and this is automated manual transmission. Then also it doesn't get that cool thing. I will make that after the video. And here this is the control for the for opening the boot, and this is the control to open the fuel cap. And the side cushioning of the seat is nice, and here this is the control to recline and incline the seat. Let me get onto the car and start the car for a moment. Press the brake pedal, then only the car will start. Okay, the car is now turned on. It is giving me good amount of air conditioning. There is no power window control, that is said you earlier. So where is the power window control? There is a power window control on the center, but there is no power window control there. That is actually cost cutting, but here you get power window control. This is to lock the power window control. Yeah, that power window is working, but the rear power window doesn't work. Yeah, I'll show you. Yeah, now it will work, and this is the control for the power window. For the front seat, yeah, it works brilliantly well, and this also works brilliantly well. And this Sandero gets both petrol and CNG, and this is automated manual transmission, but also it doesn't get dead pedal. That's obviously not satisfied with that. And while moving on to the instrument cluster, in instrument cluster, drive, neutral and reverse, then manual, plus minus, stuff like that you can see on the instrument cluster. And this is actually perfect for city driving, and the handling is not that great because this car is actually lightweight. And also like Hyundai cars, this will not offer us good amount of feel and feedback from the steering wheel. That's also actually missing from the car. And here you get black treatment, and there is no sunglass holder in the center. Obviously there is no sunglass holder in the center. Because of that I kept my sunglass here, and here also I kept my Bajaj key. That's the key for the Domino. And here blockhouse is decent in size, and here also you get dual tone color in the door pad. Here also on the doors, all the doors you get dual tone color. And this is the control for the wiper. Wipers press brilliantly well, and obviously the steering wheel offers a good amount of feel and feedback. And here there is no steering height adjust both for reach as well as brake. That's also obviously not a nice touch. On the center console you get Hyundai switch can. Yeah, so many waste papers are inside the switch can. And also there is no twin cup holders. Where is that Hyundai? And this for reverse drive, and this is for manual. But the Hyundai did a great job. They made Hyundai switch can for all the cars. That's a nice touch. And also it get this 7 inch touchscreen infotainment system that supports Apple CarPlay, and rotor connectivity, Bluetooth, as well as all of the stuffs are inside this instrument cluster. And also actually this is fluid. Yeah, it works brilliantly well, you can see that. Yeah, this car only costs 5 lakhs. Then also this types of fluid instrument cluster, Some cars has touchscreen infotainment system, but that is not actually fluid. It gets sound optimism and display, font projection, custom button, date and time, language and keyboard, screensaver, Bluetooth, remote lock and system information. And here you get clubhouse is decent in size, pro compartment is in 12 ton, and here you get decent CMT and the gear levers, whether you are in the driver, reverse or manual, or which gear you are. And this is the fuel efficiency meter. The fuel is not there in this car, and this is the odometer. To browse through the instrument cluster, what you have to do is that press this, you can browse the instrument cluster. It is average fuel and so many stuffs, but this is not actually the Astra model, so it missed out so many features. But there is actually so many cross-cutting is also happened. Here you get aux and 12 volt charging socket, absolutely nice, but it needs 12 volt charging socket at the rear, but that is not expected at this price point. Sun visor along with no mirror, along with no right rear adjustable rear view mirror without no ORVM, and here you get sun visor along with no mirror, along with no light placement in here, but you like you get a light placement in the center, no adjustable seat belt height. And this thing will obviously reminds you about the Mercedes-Benz A-Class, because this is the symbol of Mercedes-Benz. Yeah, you can see Honda copy, Hyundai copied this symbol or borrowed this symbol for the SE-Man. Actually, here you get what AC vents are quite good enough, and this is the control for the AC vents for leg. And here you get piano black finish, that's also a nice touch. And let me turn off the car for a moment. Yeah, actually power window control works brilliantly well. And also this car is good for or applicable for all riding conditions, or apply for all riding conditions. The suspension is on the smoothest side, and also AMT is automated shifting manual transmission for improved driving convenience. To start engine, press brake pedal with gear lever at neutral. Yeah, the gear lever is at neutral. Press brake pedal to change gear, drive neutral reverse. Use parking brake to avoid rollback during hill start. See owner's manual for details. But I want to say you that before you buying this car, you want to test ride for looking your height as well as the power. This car does not produce as much power, and it made a vocal sound in the top end, and the mid range is quite good enough. And also initial pulling is not that good enough, but it just rush to pull, but then also it doesn't pull as much as you expected. And here the mirror will give you obviously a nice vision. Yeah, actually I get obviously a nice vision, but this car doesn't get rose parking sensors and camera. That's actually coarse cutting. And here you get so many plastic objects, and the stitching on the seat is absolutely nice. And this car is optimum for all riding conditions. And the handling is not that great because the suspension is on the smoothest side. And also Hyundai is well good in build quality, and front seat is as comfortable as you need. Here's storage space. No 12 volt charging socket here, but you get 12 volt charging socket here. So guys, this is the review video from me. That's a Gokul PR. And if you guys want this car, first you want to test ride, then buy. Because this car missed out of so many features, but then also it will give you a good amount of comfort in the front seat as well as on the rear seat. Meanwhile, 12 volt charging sockets, rear Siemens and Hyundai switch can, and power window controls on the center. Actually that's a coarse cutting. And here clubhouse is decent in size, and here also storage space, Mercedes Benz symbol on the Siemens. And also these all things will obviously makes you to buy this car, because it gets sounds touchscreen infotainment system. Wow, you get 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system which supports Apple CarPlay, Android Auto continuity and whatnot. Then Bluetooth continuity also. All the stuffs are hidden in this car. So guys, this is the review video from me. That is Mr. Gokul PR. So if you're watching this video for the first time, subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon, and don't forget to follow me on Instagram. So let me wind up this video right again.